Hi everyone, welcome to my Photoshop tutorial, and today I'm going to teach you how to put a watermark in your images. Now first things first, you want to open your image in Photoshop, and to do that you want to go to File and Open and select your image. Once you've loaded your image in Photoshop, you want to go to Window and Actions. Now in this dialog box we're going to create a new action. So what it's going to do is it's going to record all our movements in Photoshop, so you don't have to every time create a new watermark. We can just simply click on one button and it will appear. So first of all we're going to click on the create new action icon, and we're going to name our action watermark, and then click record. Then close that dialog box down. Now if you've got, like mine, a high resolution image, it's going to be quite big. Now if I wanted to send this to someone, it's going to take a while to download and to send it to them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to scale the image down. So we'll go to image and image size. Make sure you've got resample image selected, and we're going to change the resolution to 72 and the width to 1000, and then click OK, and it's scaled our image down. Zoom in, then from here I'm going to select the text tool and then click on our image. I've put our option to 180, so that's the size of it, and then the font I'm going to change to Impact, and the colour to white. So the next step is we're going to add the copyright symbol. Now you're not going to find this on your keyboard, so first of all you want to hold down Alt and then type 0169, and then it automatically appears. Then type what you want to add, so mine's going to be Photo Pro. Now it's a bit too white for this image, and if we added this as it is now to a normal white image, then people can easily take it off. So what we're going to do is we're going to make it a little bit harder, so we're going to add another layer. Basically we're going to go down to the FX button, which is on the right hand side down the bottom, press it, and add drop shadow. Now I'm going to bring the distance to 0, so it's equal on all sides. Then we're going to press bevel and emboss, then click it. Make sure you've got the style to inner bevel, and then click OK. It looks pretty good at the moment, but we're going to bring the fill down to 20% and the opacity down to 80. Now that looks pretty good, it's tightening with everything. Now first of all we want to go to select and select all, click the little arrow icon, the move tool. Now you'll see these options at the top. You can change where you want them. Now I'm going to have mine in the middle, because then it overlaps all of the detail and it makes it harder for the person to copy your image. Then press Ctrl and D to deselect. Now we want to stop our action from recording, so we want to go to Window, Actions, and just press the little stop button, and there we go. Then we press this little arrow to tidy everything up, and we've created our watermark action. Now let's try this on a different image, so we go to this one, any image will do, and basically I don't want to create this watermark all over again, so all I've got to do is go to Windows, Action, and press the little watermark, and then press play. Give it a second and it's done it. Take the box away. Zoom in, and there you go. It's resized it for me and it's added my watermark in. Now I hope you liked the tutorial, and please comment, rate and subscribe, and also I want to say that all my tutorials now are going to be in high definition for use. So I hope you like that, and I'll see you in the next tutorial. Bye for now.